As the saying goes, home sweet home. Or would home be like the road where the Leafs have struggled? Find out next. Welcome to the Intermission on OurLeafs.com. I'm your host, Brado. Thanks for watching. Undone by a series of giveaways, turnovers, and of course costly mistakes as usual, you know, this is beginning to sound like a broken record. The Leafs lose to the LA Kings 5-3. With 30 games remaining on his contract, the young Gustafson, trying to prove that he's worthy of being the number one goaltender in Toronto, didn't exactly get the performance that he was probably looking at. He was quoted in saying, "I know it's up to me to show that I want to be here, and I want to be a goalie that the team can count on." Well, last night, as much as Gustafson tried to hold his team down, his team didn't exactly hold him in the game. The Los Angeles Kings quickly made it a 1-0 game on the power play after an Ian White penalty, thanks to former Guelph Storm Drew Doughty, and also going to be on the Olympic team. Congratulations, Drew. 4 minutes later, however, Nikolai Kuhlman tried to get something going for his team by tying the game at 1. But of course, as usual, the typical Leafs that we've seen and come to know this season showed up. One thing I've noticed about the Leafs this year is being able to sustain momentum when they get it. Kuhlman ties the game at the end of the first period, so you'd assume that the Leafs might be a little bit more energetic coming out into the second period. But the Leafs' ability to dig themselves a hole that they just can't get out of continued in the second period as Jarrett Stahl, Jack Johnson, and Ryan Smith all scored goals for the Kings to push their lead to 4-1. Nicholas Hagman tried to respond by scoring his 19th goal of the season, pushing it to a 4-2 lead after two periods of play going into the third period. But somehow I just got the feeling that this was going to be one of those nights. Once again, the inability to sustain momentum hurt the Leafs in the third period. With more mistakes, Dustin Brown, the captain of the Los Angeles Kings, was able to strip the puck away from Wayne Primeau and put it into the back of the net, beating Gustafson and making the score 5-2. It should also be noted that Dustin Brown was just recently named an assistant captain for the USA's Olympic team and also had 3 assists on the night. Pretty impressive. Nicholas Hagman would go on to score his 20th goal of the season, but it wasn't enough as the Toronto Maple Leafs lose yet again to the Los Angeles Kings 5-3. Their next upcoming game, against the Devils on Friday night, and then in Hockey Night in Canada on Saturday against the Vancouver Canucks. Game aside, let's have a talk. Leafs Nation, we need to talk. One-on-one. A mano a mano. There are some people out there that believe that the Toronto Maple Leafs are playoff-bound, and that we might actually win a Stanley Cup this year. Habsuck, we're referring to you. To address this issue, I turned to my address book and called a very good friend of mine and asked him what he thinks about the situation. I asked if he could be a guest star on my show. Here's what he had to say.
What's that? Playoffs? Don't talk about playoffs? You kidding me? Playoffs? I just hope we can win a game.
Thanks, Jim. Couldn't have said it better myself. Now, a lot of people say that Brian Burke should get rid of Ron Wilson, and that obviously the players aren't listening to the coach, and because of that, we're seeing lack of commitment, no one-on-one battles, and just a Leafs team that just really doesn't seem to care. And to this I say, you might be right, but because it's an Olympic year, and Brian Burke being the general manager of Team USA for the Olympics men's hockey team, and obviously Ron Wilson being the head coach, there's that kind of relationship there that I don't think Brian wants to tread on just yet. I think if it was not an Olympic year, Ron Wilson would probably have been canned by now. Will the Leafs be able to snap their losing streak in New Jersey? Here's hoping so. Ron Wilson and the Toronto Maple Leafs worked on one-on-one battles in practice today, something they didn't do very well against the Los Angeles Kings on Tuesday night. Well, that wraps up our first episode of The Intermission here on OurLeafs.com. Be sure to check us out and add us as a friend. Rate us, subscribe to us, leave a comment in the box there, or even follow us on Twitter and Facebook, and tell us what you think about the game. Don't forget to answer the question of the game, and as always, go Leafs, go!